Welcome back. Well, in case you didn't know, February is actually National Children's Dental Health Month, which focuses attention on the fact that more than half children in the U.S. suffer from tooth decay. And just a reminder, if left untreated, cavities can negatively impact a child's health and well-being and have even been linked to poor academic performance. So I'm happy to say that joining us today is Dr. Maria Ryan of Colgate-Palmolive Company, and they're on a mission to create a zero-cavity future for all. Welcome, Dr. Maria Ryan. It's great to see you.
Hi, Anessa. Thank you for having me on your show.
Well, these stats continue to be staggering, Dr. Ryan. Why is it, do you think, that cavities continue to be such a problem for our young children?
Well, I think, you know, it's very important that children have great oral health habits, they see the dentist frequently, and that their diet is good. And really not having a lot of sugars is very important to that. And you know, if they develop cavities, if they're left untreated, it'll impact their health, causing pain and discoloration and eventual tooth loss. And more recent findings show it impacts their social and emotional well-being, you know, creating a lack of self-esteem and poor academic performance, and that's why Colgate is on a mission to create a zero cavity future for everybody, as you mentioned earlier, really raising awareness about cavities and improving on health habits.
Well, so much is connected with our smile and the confidence that comes from it. I'm so interested to hear about the zero cavity future for all. Can you tell us about it?
Well, cavities are preventable if we have good oral health habits. So, you know, we reinforce that children and adults need to brush twice a day with a fluoride-containing toothpaste, floss at least once a day, and use mouth rinses as needed. But with children, as a parent, as a dentist, I know how hard it is to get them to do that. So we've really been working hard to make oral care fun. And so we have a new kids hum toothbrush with augmented reality and lots of fun games and rewards for good, you know, toothbrushing. We have lots of great flavors in our toothpaste that make it fun for kids to brush. And, you know, we've been taking action over the past 30 years with a program called Bright Smiles, Bright Futures, which provides oral health education and free dental screenings for communities in need in over 80 countries. And we've already reached 1.3 billion children, and we have a goal to reach 2 billion children by the year 2025. And this program has lots of fun learnings for parents, for teachers, and great reading materials for kids, appropriate ages, et cetera, in 30 languages online.
Oh, wow. Congratulations on all the success. And it always seems like in order to make it resonate with kids, you got to make it fun. And you guys nailed that. Talk to me about the pandemic, the times we're living in. Has that changed oral health with children at all?
Yeah, the pandemic, you know, like everything, has made oral health, optimal oral health, even harder because less children are seeing the dentist. There are changes in their health habits because they're learning remotely. And, you know, there was a recent paper that cited dental care as the number one unmet need for children during the pandemic. Mm-hmm. So it's really important that parents, you know, are good role models and reinforce all of the things that we talked about with their children and use fun things like Hum Kids to get them to brush and look at the materials that can educate them while they're at home and help them to keep their kids on track, because it's really important during these times.
That's right. Well, Dr. Ryan, thank you so much for all of that great information. You've motivated us for change. We will head to Colgate.com for more information. You have a wonderful day. Amber, wasn't some of that information so interesting?
It is, especially for little ones out there, right? And as
yes.
parents, that can be so challenging. So a big thank you to her as well. Okay, we are moving on with some sweet treats with a little bit of wine. Jen is here from Vino Mobile Bar. First of all, it is so good to see you.
Oh, it's been, last time I see her in person was July.
Oh,
it is
my
so,
goodness.
It's just awesome. The vibe is awesome here today.
Thank you.
Like you said, the girls are rocking it out. We got this. We got some wine.
We have wine. We have some desserts. We're basically eating our wine
We're
today,
We're going to eat our wine today. Today's National Drink Wine Day, and what it was came about is actually giving, you know, there are good health benefits to actually drinking wine, you know, lower cholesterol, you know, get your body going a little bit. So not just, it's moderately, it's not like all indulging, you know, 100%.
Right.
But so I brought in some local wines here and some fun wine desserts that we can do too.
I love this. Okay.
So I wanted to start with Chardonnay. I love Chardonnay, and I think you're also a
Chardonnay
person too.
Yes.
Yeah. So right there in that glass is a Chardonnay. Now this is from Bob Campbell, and this is a Stelman Street one. So he's a local, he lives in Carmel. So he actually makes this wine here, and it is so good.
Oh,
it
wow.
is a good, it's not really oaky, it's not really, you know, buttery, but it's really
it's
in
this
between.
One here?
It's that one right there.
Okay,
yeah, go
I'm
ahead
do
and
a
have
little
a little taste test.
And as I do my little taste test, talk to me about the benefits. Of course, all of this in moderation,
yeah,
you know, right?
Absolutely.
But there are benefits to drinking a little bit of wine.
You know, lowering your cholesterol, I think that's the biggest thing with one too. And believe me, I'm not a medical expert by all means, but what I've read, that's one of
tasty.
Them definitely. You know, keeping your heart healthy, you know, and all of those, lowering diabetes. So I think there's some good, as long as, again, drinking moderation,
right.
you know, a glass here and there, you're going to be just fine.
That's,
so
yeah. That's great. That's really good to know. Okay, let's move on.
So
what do you have
I've
next?
Got a couple of ice cream desserts because I do like to drink my wine, but I also like to eat my wine too. So what I've got here in front of you, Amber, is this is black raspberry.
Oh, so pretty.
And what you can do is you can garnish it with a mint, put a little
is
piece of chocolate
ice cream?
In it. It's ice cream. Yes, you can use sorbet, yogurt, whatever you want.
Okay.
Put a little I love whipping.
Me too.
If you are a nut person, if you're not, please leave those off.
Ooh.
And then top it off with your favorite red wine.
Oh, you
wine.
Actually put that in there.
Yes, top it right off with that. And it works the same way.
And you've got chocolate
in there too. Chocolate
oh,
in there.
Oh, this is good.
It's good, isn't it? I know. And it's just the right amount. Now, some people will actually take the ice cream, mix in with a blender with the wine, and then freeze it in a batch like that too. So you can do it multiple ways. And then the next one you have there is actually buttery pecan. Now, that does have nuts in it, so if you're allergic, don't eat that.
I'm not.
But I love a Riesling or Prosecco or something, you know, a little bit lighter and bubblier with it. And you just pour it on the top there. Add a couple additional nuts if you want to. Garnish it.
I just want to keep this.
With the mint.
I'm just
and voila. There you go. It is so cute, so pretty, and so easy.
That's
you can
so
make
good.
These ahead of time and freeze them. So if you have guests coming over as well.
Oh, wait a minute. What is this part in here? Oh, that's just part of the ice cream.
That's
almost
part of the
looks
ice cream.
Like cake.
Yeah, it's part of the ice cream in there. It actually has chocolate chunks in there as well, too.
Oh, it does. That's
good
part of why.
Absolutely.
I feel like this would be a great get together if you're able to have, you know, of course, even some family members in your home, obviously, with the social distancing right now. But even for future use, having a little get together with desserts like this
and make
wine.
It and pre-make them. Absolutely. But not only do you can drink out of the wine bottles, the wine cans. Now, these hit 2017.
It's
this
really
is when they really
that's
made
really
their
good,
hit.
Jen.
I know it's really good, isn't it? I know. I've got the extras for later.
I always say, I don't have to take more than one bite.
What do you think we're having for dessert tonight, Amber?
That is so good. Okay, first of all, I complimented this container.
Oh, yes.
This is the perfect use for something like this. But what are these?
So wine cans came out in 2017.
Wine cans?
Wine cans, yes. And so we started carrying them on the wine truck, and they were a hit. So I grabbed some, I call them local because they pretty much are. It's Michigan. It's just right upstairs.
Oh, cool.
Yeah, and so this is a local winery in Michigan here. And then also, I mean, there's a varietals. I mean, there's every type of thing. This actually is a cider. So if you're into ciders, they now have canned ciders too.
Oh, neat.
So, I mean, there's bubblies, there's rosés, there's chardonnays, you name it, it's out there. So there's probably about 200 different varietals of different cans out
that
there.
That is really cool. It's just amazing how it just keeps
evolving.
Growing and growing and growing. And speaking of evolving, how has it been for you?
We actually got through 2020 just fine. We did a lot of smaller parties, which was great. We're looking at 2021. Weddings are being booked, you know, festivals and whatever's going to come back about again. So we're looking forward to 2021. This is our ramp up back year again.
Ramp up back year.
Yeah.
I like that. Is there a most popular type of wine right now or something that's popular on TikTok like that pasta recipe is that we're going to see coming up?
Well, moms are doing workouts with their bottles of wine. So that's
oh, so you're just like taking
weights.
These
exactly.
and doing weights.
Yep.
There you go.
Exactly.
That's all you need.
It is the year of the red, so that's a good thing.
Oh,
but in Indiana, we are a sweeter state, so we stick with our Prosecco's
like
and our Rieslings
wines.
And our, you know, and our rosés.
Yeah.
So, yeah.
Jen, thank you so much. We can learn more at VinoMobileBar.com,
yes.
right?
Mm-hmm.
Perfect. We'll put that link on IndyStyle.tv. Jen, thank you so much.
Thank you.
I appreciate it. I don't know. Maybe one of these will go viral, perhaps, in Essex. You never know.